listeners. I welcome you all to another episode of my weekly online chemistry class. I believe you enjoyed the previous videos that were uploaded. In the previous episode, we discussed mesomeric effect in addition to what we have as conjugative effect. And in that episode, I told you that mesomeric effect usually occurs in a pi system as against the inductive effect that do take place in a sigma bond. In addition to that, I also mentioned to you that mesomeric effect can be elongated with more carbon atoms, provided the carbon atoms are linked together with conjugative arrangement of double bond. And that was why I told you that there are three major types of double bond arrangement, which are cumulated, conjugated, as well as isolated. Today, we are going to discuss another topic that is similar to mesomeric effect, only that there is a little difference between them, and that is what we refer to as electromeric effects. Electromeric effect, by definition, is an effect that occurs when an attacking reagent, which can be a nucleophile or an electrophile, attacks a pi system and the charge is being taken away from that reagent to one of the carbon atoms that bears the double or multiple covalent bonds. So that means electromeric effect is also occurs in a pi system. But the difference between this effect and that of mesomeric effect is that for electromeric effect to take place, there must be the presence of an attacking reagent. And that is why we refer to it as a temporary effect. For instance, if you have, in addition to that, this effect is divided into two. We have positive electromeric effects and we have negative electromeric effects, depending on the nature of the attacking reagent, whether it is an electrophile or a nucleophile. So when the attacking reagent is an electrophile, that effect is known as electromeric effect. Take for instance, you have an electrophile attacking a pi bond system. Okay? The pi bond electron between the two carbon atoms attack the electrophile here, and that results to the formation of EC. Okay? Then you have something of this nature, a positive charge. So the positive charge on the electrophile has now been taken away and towards one of the carbon atoms that bear the double bond. This is what we refer to as electromeric effect. And this kind of effect usually occurs in electrophilic substitution reactions of benzene. Take for instance alkylation, Friedel-Crafts acylation, or Friedel-Crafts halogenation of benzene. If you look at benzene, there is a pi system here. When you react this with an electrophile, let's say a nitronium ion, and this pi bond attacks this, you are going to have an intermediate structure of NO2, then hydrogen, then you have a positive charge here. So you can see that the pi bond is between these two carbon atoms. Since the pi bond electrons has been taken away to form a bond with the electrophile, so the positive charge on the electrophile will come and to attack the other carbon atoms of the pi bond system with that is not being attached to the electrophile. So this kind of electromeric effect is what we refer to as positive electromeric effect. Then we have the negative electromeric effect. When a nucleophile attacks the pi system, anytime a nucleophile or pi attack a pi system, the electron on the nucleophile will attack or will be taken to attack one of the carbon atoms and the other carbon atoms as against the one the nucleophile is attached to. Take for instance, you have a nucleophile here attacking a pi bond system. Okay? So the negatively charged on the nucleophile, as if it attacks this carbon atom, then the pi bond electron will shift on the carbon atom, on the other carbon. And that will give you something of this nature. You have nucleophile, carbon, then you have carbon positive, negative charge. Negative charge. So this is what we refer to as a nucleophile, a negative electromagnetic effect. An example is you have a chloride ion plus, let us assume you have H2, then you have fluorine here, and you have hydrogen here. So the chloride ion will attack, out of these two carbon atoms, one is richer in electrons than the other. Because this carbon atom is attached to fluorine, and fluorine is an electron withdrawing group. So that means the fluorine atom withdraws the pi bond electron in between the two carbon atoms away from this carbon atom to itself, thereby making this carbon to be positively charged and making this carbon to be negatively charged. So the negatively charged electron on chlorine will attack this carbon atom, and that will result to something of this nature, where you have CH2Cl, then you have F and hydrogen, then this is a negatively charged. So this type of system is what we refer to as electromagnetic effect. And I told you once again that electromagnetic effect is similar to mesmeric effect, only the difference being that this one only occurs when there is a presence of an electron, an attacking reagent. While mesmeric effect can occur in the absence of an attacking reagent. Another factor is what we refer to as steric effect. Steric. Steric effect usually occurs when there is a bulky group attached to the point of reaction, to the reaction site of an organic compound. When there is a bulky group attached to this reaction site of an organic compound. And that bulky group may lead either increase the reactivity of that compound or reduce its reactivity. And when it increases its reactivity, we refer to it as steric acceleration. Steric acceleration. But when it reduces the reactivity of that compound, we refer to it as steric hindrance. Now, let me demonstrate these two effects, or these two types of steric effect to you. Now, from the first one, take for instance, I'm going to use alcohol, and we have three major types of alcohol. Alcohol is of this kind, whether primary, secondary, or tertiary. And alcohol can undergo reaction, either by the cleavage of the oxygen-hydrogen bond, or the cleavage of the carbon-oxygen bond. When they react by the cleavage of the oxygen-hydrogen bond, there is going to be formation of alkoxide and hydrogen ion. When they react by the cleavage of the carbon-oxygen bond, there is going to be formation of alkyl carbonium ion and hydroxy ion. Now, under what condition will make alcohol to undergo this type of cleavage or the other one? That also depends on the nature of the carbon atom that bears the hydroxy group, the one we refer to as the carbinol. For instance, when you have a tertiary alcohol, C, R, 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 O, H, the three alkyl group makes this carbon to be bulky in nature and imposes what we call steric effect. Because of the bulky nature, and do not forget that alkyl groups are electron-releasing groups. Because they are electron-releasing groups, they make it easy or easier for the breaking of the bond between carbon and oxygen to form tertiary carbonium ion and hydroxy group. Because the positively charged carbon will be stabilized by the three alkyl groups, which are electron-releasing groups. So, since the bulkiness of this favors the breaking of the carbon-oxygen bond, then it can be referred to as steric effect. And don't forget, any substance that produces hydroxy ion as the only negative ion in solution is referred to as B. So that means breaking of the bond between carbon and oxygen in alcohol makes them to be basic. And the bulkiness of the group favors their basicity. So that means the breaking of the bond between carbon and oxygen is favored by two factors, positive inductive effect by the alkyl group and the bulkiness, which is steric acceleration or simply steric effect. Now, for the steric hindrance, for instance, if you look at this molecule, you have N, CH3, then lone pair of electron. This is N,N-dimethylalanine compared to alanine itself. Where you have this, this, this. In alanine, the low pair electron on hydrogen atom can easily be delocalized within the benzene ring to form various canonical structures. We are coming to that when we get to resonance. But here, the two methyl groups attached to the nitrogen atom here makes it difficult for the electron pair to be delocalized within the ring. So in that case, we say the bulkiness of this nitrogen reduces the delocalization of the electron, and that is what we refer to as steric hindrance. Another effect of steric hindrance is observed, whereby the breaking of the bond between oxygen and hydrogen in alcohol is difficult in tertiary alcohol compared to primary alcohol. That is why alcohols are referred to as amphoteric organic compounds, because they have both acidic property by releasing and producing hydrogen ion, and basic properties by producing hydroxyl ion. So in that case, in one of the previous episodes, I mentioned that you should be able to explain or give an account for why it is easier to esterify ethanoic acid with ethanol than 2,2-dimethylpropanoic acid with ethanol. Let me demonstrate that with chemical equations. Then you know what I mean by steric hindrance and steric acceleration. This is ethanol, ethanoic acid plus ethanol to give us ethyl ethanoate. Then this is a 2,2-dimethyl propanoic acid with ethanol to give us 2,2-dimethylpropanoate. We discover that it is easier, the reaction is faster here, and the reaction is slower here. Why? Because the two methyl group attached to carbon 2 or propanoic acid imposes positive inductive effect, and the bulkiness of the group makes it difficult for the molecule to release hydrogen ion as a positive ion, as compared to what you have here, whereby this is less bulky, and as a result of that, it can easily release hydrogen ion to hydroxyl ion to form water, while the ethyl group is attached to the carboxylate to give us carboxylic the ester product. Again, it is easier to esterify ethanoic acid faster with the 2,2-dimethylpropanoate than ethanoic acid with ethanol. Okay, this one, this is 2-methylpropan-2-O. The reaction is faster here, while the reaction is slower here, because the bulkiness of the alcohol favors the basicity of alcohol and thereby increases the rate of esterification. Unlike here, where the bulkiness of this carboxylic acid does not favor the acidity of the compound and thereby lower the rate of esterification of the reaction. So in this, I believe you have learned the major difference between electromeric effect and mesomeric effect. And again, what do you mean by steric effect? For a steric effect to occur, there must be bulky group attached to the reaction site of an organic compound. And when it favors the reactivity of that compound, it is referred to as steric acceleration, as explained here. But when it is against the reactivity of that compound, it is referred to as steric hindrance, both of which are steric effect in nature. Do not forget, again, to like, comment, subscribe, and share the video. And I believe you have learned one or two things today. In our next episode, we are going to consider the other factors that affect reactivity and polarity of organic molecules. Thanks for watching and stay safe.